I must say, this Hemnes desk is one of the most stable desks I've reviewed so far, but there are some things I want to show you before you decide to purchase it. So let's start with the worktop. As you can see, it's not a small desk. You get about 61 inches in width and about 25.5 inches in depth. You'll have plenty of space to organize your desk essentials like laptops, monitors, desk lamps, and more. Now at the back of the worktop, you get a cable outlet. You have the option of leaving it closed, or you can twist it open so you can run your wires through. This part of the desk will help you keep your wires more organized. Right underneath the cable outlet, there's a shelf where a smaller size power block can be stored. If any of your wires are on the shorter end, you won't have to figure out ways to directly connect it to the outlet on the wall. Also, as you may have noticed, there are two wire outlets on either side of this shelf. I don't think you'll be using both at the same time, but you can utilize one of them if you decide to store a desktop in the cabinet. The cabinet can be assembled either on the right side or the left side, and it comes with an adjustable shelf. You have the option to take the shelf out and use this space to put a desktop if you want to create more of a concealed look. There are openings in the back and the underside of the cabinet to run your wires through that can also help with the airflow in regards to the desktop. If you don't think that's enough space for airflow, then you might have to make some alterations to this area. You can always keep your cabinet door open if your desktop is running. So the dimensions of the desktop have to be less than 20 inches in height, 11.5 inches width-wise if you take the door out, and about 20 inches in depth. But if you decide to keep the shelf in, then you'll have enough space to store any of your binders or notebooks. And I would like to point out that I didn't see any issues with opening and closing the cabinet door. I noticed that the door for the cabinet comes with a soft close feature, which gives off the impression that it's of higher quality. As for the two drawers on the other side, they open and close relatively smoothly. I'm also glad that when I was moving the drawers from side to side, I only noticed some slight movement. With the top drawer, you get a small compartment where you can store smaller items like paper clips or binder clips. You can also store bigger objects like rulers, calculators, and staplers in the actual drawer itself. With the bottom drawer, this is where you can keep your files for either work or personal receipts. You have the option of adjusting the plastic holders to either fit folders that are letter, A4, or legal sized. If you don't need the space for files, you can always take out the two frames and use this drawer as extra storage for your desk essentials. In regards to the leg space, I still think it's fine. I'm 6 feet tall, and the space definitely feels enclosed, but not crammed. You may have some issues with this space if you have a wider desk chair, but if you want to see if your desk chair can fit under this desk, the height of the armrest should be less than 26.5 inches. I would also like to add that the bottom of the legs come with plastic scratch guards to protect your floors, and this desk comes with a finished backing, so you can place it anywhere in your room. Doesn't necessarily need to be against the wall. But before you buy this IKEA desk, one thing I would like to bring to your attention is that it's mostly made out of pine. Pine is a softwood, so you can expect the legs and the worktop to show dents over time. With this desk, you'll just have to be a bit more careful, but overall, I think it's a pretty solid desk. If you're interested, right now it also comes in a black, brown, and white stained. It'll take you quite some time to assemble the whole desk, but I do have a tutorial to help speed up the process. The Hemnes desk comes in two boxes that can be transported in a smaller car, and right now you can purchase it for $299 in Canada and America.
Smash that like button if you enjoyed the video, and screw that subscribe button if you want to see more furniture review videos.